Good morning, everyone.
Hey, now.
Good morning.
All right. We want to welcome everyone. Welcome everyone watching, streaming this live, watching at home. Welcome everyone here. Pray that this will be a blessed time for you today. We know that God has something for you here today. We're going to start with a song that's kind of our hope, like as believers in Jesus. Revelation 21 describes what quite a bit of what heaven will be like, that there will be no more crying, no more pain, and that his glory is going to light the city.
Yes.
You know, I guess it's true that, it is true. That if you're born once, you die twice. But if you're born twice, you die once. Are y'all thinking about that? But seriously, if you're born again, you're born once of your mother, born again of the Spirit, you only die once. Because there'd be absence in the body, there'd be in the presence of the Lord. Can I get an amen? What's going on here? Everybody muted because he got your face mask on or something? We got the mute button on in here? All right.
I am gold.
be shaken. We will not be moved. Jesus, you are here. Oh,
carrying our burden, covering our shame. He has overcome. Yes, he has overcome. We will not be shaken. We will not be moved. Jesus, you are here.
I will live. Yeah,
yeah. I will live. I will not die. The resurrection power of Christ. The life is peace. And I am free. In Jesus' name.
Declare.
Let's sing that together. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my daily bread.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
This is my daily bread.
Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
You love me. Come on, church, sing with us.
We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord, right now. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord, right now.
Yes, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Come on, church. Let's praise him. Come on, let's praise him. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on. There seems to be a heavy spirit in here. God wants to break through. Come on. Let it begin with your praise. Don't worry about nobody else next to you. You just begin to praise him. We bind the devil right now. We bind the devil right now. We bind the devil right now. We speak liberty in this place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, come on, come on. Come on, get free. Come on, get free. I don't know what's happened to you this week. But God wants to free you right now. Come on, free, be free, be free. Some of you may have had a good week, but the spirit of heaviness got on you. But you begin to praise right now. Oh, we bind the devil right now. We lift you up, Lord. We lift you up, Lord. Come on, come on. Break every chain, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, come on. Come on, your life is not your own. Come on, give yourself away to the Lord right now. Give yourself away to Him right now. Give yourself away to Him right now. My life is not my own, Lord. I give you all right now, Jesus. I give it all to you right now, Jesus. No, we're not moving until God's done with us. We're not moving until God is done with us. Shape our hearts, oh God. Take this praise, oh Lord. I thank you, Jesus. No, the devil has been trying to stop you. He's been trying to hinder you. He's been trying to make sure that you don't continue in him. He's been trying to do his best. And somehow, some way, you let him pull on you. But God says you can be free right now. You can cast him off of you right now. You can begin to shout and be free. You can dance like David danced right now. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory, 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 glory. Thank you, Jesus. Change the atmosphere, Lord. Change the atmosphere, Lord. Change the atmosphere, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your name, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory.
Do you believe the word when it says that whatsoever we bind on earth is bound in heaven, and whatever we loose on earth is loosed in heaven? We have to take our authority. We have power and authority. The enemy has some power too, but we have authority. I just need those who believe this, because maybe some of you are listening and it's going in one ear and out the other, but I know the enemy's been attacking, and I know specifically there have been the spirits of fear, depression, and torment. If it's not you, it's not you, but if it is you, I'm going to ask you to stand with me and let's bind those spirits. If we bind them, they have to be bound. I know I'm not the only one, and it's all right if only two or three of you stand up, because that's two or three people that can walk in more victory and more freedom And maybe the two of us can link together and want to chase 1,000, but two could chase 10,000. I know the devil is busy. I know what he's whispering in your ear. I know what he's trying to do to your body. But we have authority and power. Bind that devil. Maybe you're free, but you see a sister struggling. You see a brother with his head down. You've had visions of people walking in depression. Bind that devil for them. Did you also know that the Bible says when a thief be caught in the act, he not only has to give back what he stole, but sevenfold. Come on, let's catch the devil in his act. Catch him. Catch him. Devil, there it is. There it is. There it is. Oh, God, there it is. I felt that fear coming on me, and it caused me to shrink back. But I caught it just in time. Devil, give me back my strength, my power, my joy, sevenfold. I bind the spirit of fear. I bind the spirit of torment. I bind the spirit of depression. Oh, there it is. I bind the spirit of suicide. I bind it in the name of Jesus. I bind it in the name of Jesus. Devil, you have to loose. You have to loose. You have to loose. You have to loose. Come on, you gotta wanna be free. You gotta wanna be free. You gotta wanna be free. You gotta be tired of that devil on your back. You gotta be tired. And then take your power. Take your authority. Take it back. Take it back. Come on, get all the way in this thing. Take it back. Take it back. Take it back. It's the power of life and death is in your tongue. You ought to open your mouth and talk back to the devil. He don't mind talking to you. You ought to open your mouth and talk back to that devil. Oh, I thought it in my heart. I prayed it in my mind. Well, say it out of your mouth because your words have power. I meditated on it. Well, say it out of your mouth. People might think I'm crazy. That's all right. You don't know the hell I'm trying to get out of. That's all right. You don't know the freedom that I'm going for. That's all right. I'll be a little crazy to you, but I'm going to walk in power and victory. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Pastor Derek is in the flow. He said there's heaviness in here. Yes, there is. Let's shake out of it. Shake yourself. Shake yourself. Shake yourself. Shake yourself. Go ahead, Minister Pathedia. Shake yourself. Shake yourself.
Your name, we lift you up, we praise your name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. 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 We lift your name up. We praise you, Lord. We lift your name up. We praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank 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 you, Lord. Hallelujah, Father, right now in your name, Jesus. We give you all glory and honor right now, Lord. We praise you for who you are, Lord. Lord, right now in your name, Jesus, Lord, we ask that you purify our hearts and our minds, God. Lord, cleanse us from all unrighteousness, Lord. Lord, we ask that you just touch Iona right now in your name, Jesus, Lord. Touch her right now in your name, Father. Lord, let us surrender unto your will, Lord. Let us submit unto you, God. Lord, we ask that you just touch Jamie right now in your name, Jesus, Lord. That they do the right thing, Lord, and they surrender unto you, God. Lord, right now, your name, Jesus, Lord. Lord, touch her mental health right now in your name, Jesus, Lord. Lord, right now in your name, Jesus, Lord, we speak healing, Lord. Lord, for Kim Scott right now in your name, Jesus, Lord. Lord, we bind whatever sickness that's coming up against her, Lord. Lord, heal her of her cough and congestion, Lord. Lord, we ask that you just continue to strengthen Bishop, Lord. Lord, continue to lift him up, Lord. Lord, continue to heal him, oh God. Lord, we thank you, Jesus, Lord, for his endurance, Lord, for his strength, Lord, for your will that you put within him, God. We lift your name on high, Lord Jesus, Lord. Lord, we just praise you, Lord, right now. We give you glory and honor, Lord. Lord, we ask that you just touch all those that are backslidden and lost, Lord. All those that have offended your children, Lord, right now, Lord. Touch them in your name right now, Jesus, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. We give you glory and honor, Lord. Lord, we lift your mighty name on high, Lord. We know that all of our prayers are answered according to your will, Lord. And upon our faith, Lord, we trust and we believe in you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, Lord, we pray. We say amen. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Oh, bless his name. All right, can we take up an offering right now? So, a few months ago, or probably 4 or 5 months ago, I get a phone call. And it's a man whom I had never met, but I used to work with his wife back in the day. And he introduced himself, and I knew of him. And he told me that he was one of the program managers or what have you of this radio station, Boomer radio station. And so he says, I'm looking at starting an R&B segment, Motown R&B, Mondays from 6 to 8, will pay you well. But I want you to co-DJ with it, with me on this show. And I thought, okay, why are you calling me? And he said, well, I got your name from someone who said that you knew a lot about music trivia, soul music, your love of music, and you're a conversationalist. And he says, I think you're the best one for the job. So to make a long story longer, I said, well, you know, I'm not sure if I want to do this, right? I said, I gotta pray about this, right? Gotta see what my Lord would have me to do. That man must have called me every week, if not once, twice a week. We want you, we want you. And so I asked for counsel from those in the body. And then I continued to pray. And I wrestled with it for quite some time. And I thought, wow, you know, this is, I've never done it before. This is probably an opportunity. But then the day that I told him I would make a firm decision, as I woke up that morning, there's a song that kept going through my head. And normally I wake up with, you know, praising the Lord or thanking him or a song in my heart. But this day, there was a song in my head. And it's an old song. Wait, I know Bishop would know it. Some of y'all would know it. BT Express. It's a song called Do It Till You're Satisfied.
Whatever it is.
Do it. Do it. Stop playing. And that song kept going through my head. And I remembered some of the lyrics. And there's some of the lyrics that says, you know what? Do whatever you want. Just take some time. Relax your mind. Whatever you want to do, just do it. Do it till you're satisfied. And the Lord said, daughter, that's not of me. And I knew then there was my answer because I want to please him. And so before I could even pick up the phone to call him, he called me, this man. I even went to the radio station, toured it just to make sure I'm checking everything, you know, and nice layout and everything else. And so I said, you know, his name is Barry. I said, Barry, I got to tell you. I said, I heard a definitive word from the Lord today, and I can't. I'm out. I'm going to tell you why. It's because when you put together your playlists, I have nothing to do with that. That's the program station. You guys do what you want to do. But you may ask me to spin a record that I don't agree with. Right? If I'm listening to the radio or Sirius XM, you know, driving down the road or what have you, talk radio, and there's something I don't want to hear, I will turn the channel. I said, I don't want to go on disrupting what you guys are doing. So you may ask me to spin a song like Me and Mrs. Jones, We Got a Thing Going On. I can't, I said, I can't connect with that. I don't want to spin that. There was a part of me that said, do it, because I was even going to, I had a DJ name, thought about that, everything. I said, I might blow up. They'll see my face on the side of a bus and, sponsored by Boomer Radio and DJ blah, 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 whatever. But that was all flesh. That was all me. That was all me. But to lay that down, because I thought about Moses, where he laid down the pleasures of sin so that he could be with the people of God. I would share the affliction with the people of God than to satisfy my flesh. So now's the time, saints of God, men and women of God, you know, when we made our decision that I will follow Christ, that means you got to lay down you and pick up him. I don't care how famous you think it might make you. All right? All right. Come on, stand to your feet. Oh, hallelujah. It's all in him. It's all in him. The fullness of the Godhead. It's all in him. It's all in him. It's all in him. The mighty God is Jesus, and it's all in him. It's all in him. It's all in him. The fullness of the Godhead. It's all in him. It's all in him. It's all in him. The mighty God is Jesus, and it's all in him. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood. Oh, there is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood. Oh, the Lamb, there is power, power, wonder-working power in the shed blood of the Lamb. Oh, there is power. In the blood of the Lamb, there is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb.
live, so I'm gonna live so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm gonna live so God can use me anywhere, Lord, any. Oh, now I'm gonna pray so. Anytime, I'm gonna pray so God can use me anywhere, Lord, any. Oh, now I'm gonna give so. Hey, anywhere, Lord, anytime, I'm gonna give so God can use me. Lord, in last time, oh, now I'm gonna live so. Hey, anyway, Lord, anytime, I'm gonna live so. God can use me anyway, Lord, anytime.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Oh, I thank God. You know, every time I come up here, I get these little jiggles in my stomach, you know, and I'm like, God, you know, just use me, you know. You know, and I just know that that's no one but the enemy, you know. And I know that I've been blessed with the gift of singing, you know, but it never fails. It always happens. Every time, you know, I'm allowed to come up here to sing a song, I just get a little jittery, like, oh God, yeah. So I get kind of nervous, but I just praise and thank God that God has not given me the spirit of fear. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He has not given me the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. And I give him all the glory, honor, and praise. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Lord, if I find favor in your sight, Lord, please hear my heart's cry. I'm desperately waiting to be. I travel near or far for your glory. I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my king for your glory. I will do just to see you, to behold you as my King. Lord, if I find favor,
if I find favor,
just to be where you
are,
across the highest
distance,
I'll travel near or far.
Travel near or far.
gotta be where you are. I wanna be where, dwelling in your presence.
Gotta be where,
dwelling in your spirit.
Wanna be where,
I gotta be there. Oh, yeah. I gotta be there, Lord. All in your presence.
Wanna be where,
oh, Jesus, I need to be there. I gotta be there. I wanna be where.
Thank you, Jesus. done for me. Thank you for my church. Thank you for our bishop who teaches and loves us. Thank you for Camille. Oh my gosh, who stood by me through so much all these years. I know that you are just like me. We're all just alike. We have things that we are grateful for. We have done things we're ashamed of. Aren't you so glad that he doesn't just turn his back and walk away? Ooh, because I know I'm not deserving. And he hears me when I say, help me be a better person? Can you help me be a better mother? Can you help me be a better grandmother? A better church member? Can you help me be bold? Can you help me tell someone, even if you think they might resent you or put you back, just tell them about you? Oh, Jesus. I know. I know you love me, Jesus. I know you love me, Jesus. I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful. And he hears me when I
the Lord. If everybody doesn't know, Tuesday I had a total knee replacement. Does it? I'm not high. Camille scolded me and took me off the narcotics Wednesday evening. Oh, Thursday, we're there. Thursday, okay. I told her she was Nurse Jackie, you know. She's saving some. You know, saving some for when Mike called. My back hurt. Honey, I got some hydrocodone right here. Oh, Mimi, you in pain, baby? I have some. We got oxy right here. So when she was scolding me, I told her, well, you're the one that's telling me what to take and everything. Well, no, you don't take this all the time. You need Tylenol now. Okay. Well, I thought I was supposed to at least take what the doctor gave me when he prescribed, you know. I wasn't making the decisions, you know. Praise the Lord. But she's been caring for me well, so. But today's message is one that I think is very important for us. Children. Oh, the children. Children? The little people are dismissed to their classes. It was going with the two. They weren't moving. Yeah, but today's message is one that I think is very important for us all, you know. Because you get to a point in your Christian life where, you know, you've been going on and doing everything and living like you're, you know, what, I'm supposed to be this, I'm supposed to do that, what have you. And question comes at some point, are you in? Are you all the way in? And I want to demonstrate that to you in the Bible, how that's an important thing. And at some point, God demonstrated that with the people of God that were, no, well, you're an Israelite. Well, you obviously are my child. But I want to know, are you in?
Right, right, right.
Now, you go to church. Oh, you've been baptized. I want to know, are you in, though? When all is said and done, you've sung the songs, you've praised the Lord, you've waved your hands, and you've done all this stuff. Are you really in? Are you in all the way? It remains your choice. It's your choice. I want to begin with in a book in Judges chapter 6. Some of you are familiar with Gideon. He's in the book of Judges. And at one time in Israel, the people of God, they had judges. And the judge was somebody who kind of determined, ran, was the head of everyone in the country and in Israel. And many of the judges got them out of trouble. They were in some sort of trouble, and God called someone to get them out of trouble. And Gideon was one of those people. And just so you know, when God called Gideon, he didn't want to do it. He didn't want to do it. In fact, he had all kind of excuses that you might think are legitimate. He said, the tribe that I'm in is the least in Israel. And my family is the least in the tribe. And I'm the least in my family.
That's right.
You can't be talking to me.
That's right. That's right.
Amen.
And today, since my leg is hurting, y'all feeling sorry for me, I'm going to name names.
Uh-oh.
I think I can get away with some stuff today.
Uh-oh.
Praise the Lord. Oh, Bishop, he didn't mean it. Yes, I did. I meant it. I just thought you felt sorry and wouldn't, you know, be angry with me. Praise the Lord. But in Judges chapter 6, verse 36 through 40, it says, "And Gideon said unto God, If thou wilt save Israel by my hand, as thou hast said, behold, I will put a fleece of wool in the floor, and if the dew be on the fleece only, and it be dry upon all the earth beside, then shall I know that thou wilt save Israel by mine hand, and thou as thou hast said." And it was so. For he rose up early on the morrow and thrust the fleece together and wring the dew out of the fleece, a bowl full of water. And Gideon said unto God, "Let not thine anger be hot against me, and I will speak but this once. Let me prove, I pray thee, but this once with the fleece. Let it now be dry only upon the fleece, and upon all the ground let there be dew." And God did so that night, for it was dry upon the fleece only, and there was dew on all the ground. Praise the Lord. See, here the issue was, Gideon was not in. Not yet. He wasn't in yet. Not all the way in. Not in his mind.
Yes.
See, he was still a little unsettled, or really having difficulty believing. If God tells you something can happen, I'm going to do this with you. And you know, like us, like ministers today, you know, like Veronica, I almost said a name. Like, well, what happens is we have our excuses, and our excuses kind of say or indicate what you really are hung up on.
Yeah.
When Gideon went through this test, he gave God the most magnificent test. He said, "Let the fleece be the only thing. Do only fall on the fleece." Now, that would be enough for me.
Right.
But he said, "No, after that, I want you to just let the fleece be dry."
Yeah.
God did everything that he asked. He's suffering him to go through this thing of unbelief. He's unsettled. And God is saying, I'm going to use you to overthrow the devil on your job, in your hood, wherever it is. And you're going to benefit folks around you. But you're like Gideon. You're not completely in unbelief. You're not completely in unbelief. Because if you read the scriptures before the ones that we read, Gideon had gathered folks together. He had gathered people all together for the battle. But you need to check some things out before you commit all the way. See, no, he had all the other tribes, Israel, come together. No, we have to fight these people. We have to do this. But you're not ready all the way. In your mind, you're still not ready. You're still going to go to God after you got all these people ready and stuff and say, I need to put this fleece out, God. Can you show me how to do what the dew can only be here and then the dew can only be there? Go ahead. Get your fleece out. Whatever it is, because you got one. You got one. You have a fleece that you want to set out before God before you want to do anything. God say, hey, I want you to do this. I want you to do that. And you got something that, well, if that's happened, Lord, if you'll do this, if you'll do that. Before you'll say yes, Lord. Oh, you said that at church. You sang that if there was a song. Oh, Lord, I'm yours, or whatever. I don't know the song. But whatever, you might have sang that. You might have said that and said that to somebody. I give myself to you, Lord, completely. I submit myself to you, Lord. But when God asks you to do something, you're not really submitted. Go ahead and put your fleece out, whatever it is, if you want to test the Lord. But all he wants to know is, are you in? I just want to know, are you in? You've been in church shouting, waving your hands. You've been doing this, doing that, saying this, saying that. But are you in? That's all. I want to know that. Praise the Lord. Look at Matthew chapter 1, verse 18. Praise the Lord. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When as his mother Mary was a spouse of Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. And in Isaiah 7 and 14, you see when that actually happened. In Isaiah, 600 years before the incarnation of Christ, he said, therefore, the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son and shall call his name Emmanuel. So here's what you have Joseph. Obviously, Joseph is in a situation where I don't care how much Holy Ghost you got. You know, Joseph wasn't, the Holy Ghost wasn't given yet. I don't care how much you into God.
Right.
No, I'm in Israel. I'm a just man and all this kind of stuff. I ain't got this little woman here. And oh, she all cute and everything. Everybody tell me, oh, what a lovely bride. Oh, look at Joseph Mary. They going to get married, y'all. And stuff like that. And oh, you pregnant. Whoa. Who? You know? Who the baby for? Who the papa? You know? Who the papa, you know? I want to know who the papa, you know? Because I know you and I, you know, although we thought about it.
Right. Come on, Bishop.
We thought about it. Well, we're going to be married, you know.
Right.
I know people that they went in and they were planning to get married, and they had sex, and then they felt like, well, I have to marry this person now. I don't matter what the Holy Ghost say. I got to marry him, otherwise I'll fornicate it. No, that happens. You understand? But Joseph in a situation where, no, I'm with this woman, and now something needs to happen. But there's some things in here that I think we miss in the prophecy and in the story and what the angel told Joseph. Because the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph. I'm reminding you of something. You studied, boy. You a Jewish boy. You had to go to synagogue. You know about what Isaiah prophesied. Let me remind you. Certain things that you need to understand. He said this, just so we can settle your mind. Behold, a virgin shall be with child. Yes, she's a virgin. She's going to be with child. But Joseph, you understand this. But telling you that the Holy Ghost, she's considered, don't be afraid, just go ahead. Now you understand this, and we're going to call his name Emmanuel. God is with us. Come on now, you understand what's going on. See, Joseph, we need you not to just play along. We need you to be in. You know how the Christmas card is going to look with Mary standing there holding the baby with no daddy, an unwed mother.
Come on. That's right.
Hey, Pastor Jackson, that's right. Boy, you know this ain't about no Christmas cards. But that's something to consider. You know, when you see Mary and Joseph together, you understand you can't have her walking around an unwed mother. That's socially unacceptable and biblically unacceptable. But in reality, Christ was not Joseph's son. He wasn't your son. Praise the Lord. You know, but Joseph, we need you to be all the way in. So let me give you a sign. You might need a sign. So I'm going to give you a sign so that you don't put Mary away and alter what God is doing in your lives. See, sometimes you need a sign. God trying to do something in your life and you're about to blow it up because you're not in all the way. You don't really believe. You don't trust what God is saying to you. See, I wish it were not true, but when God called me to be a pastor, he had people telling me for about 8 months, why don't you be our pastor? And then we always come to church. Because the people I was having Bible studies with, they would not come to church. You know? And Susie's one of them. Couldn't pay her to come to church. Come on, Susie, why don't y'all come to church? Y'all live closer to the church than me. Why don't you be our pastor, you know? Another group. Oh, took them all around North Omaha trying to find a church. You go ahead, let me just find a true church you can go to. Spent that Sunday, no reading, no happenings.
Come on, Bishop.
Finally, I need another sign. I'm going to fast for 7 days, Lord. Now, you know how I like to eat. And, you know, we in Omaha. Now, I ain't been this righteous in a long time, fasting for 7 days, you know. Fasted for 7 days. After the fast, it was probably 3 months later, and Susie had gone to church. She said, I'm not going no more. I say, round up the Bible study people. I'm going to round up this group. We're going to meet here on Sunday. But I needed a sign. See, we need signs. We need something to tell us. God just trying to find, are you in? Are you in? If I call you to do something, I say I want you to be this or do this, are you in?
Right.
What's your reason for not being in? Is it too small for you? Is it not have enough pride or glory for you? Is it too big? Oh, I can't do that. You know, you have a bunch of excuses why you're not worthy. Well, you're not worthy for anything that God does for you. You're not worthy for that car you're praying. Oh, God, if I can get this job or this car. You're not worthy for that either. But you ain't going to quit praying for it. You know there's about 4 channels of prayer that you could get on. Some people are only on supplication. No, we haven't gotten to prayer. intercession. Yes, yeah, you're the on them, only on supplication. God, give me. Glory to God. But Joseph wasn't all the way in, and we need you in, Joseph. Now Jesus is asking you collectively and individually, are you in? No, I get it. I love the Lord. Excuse me. Are you in? They got folks speaking in tongues. They're not in. Glory to God. Here's another little thing you could determine. You know, when somebody needs prayer, do you say, oh, let's call Bishop or get Pastor Derek? Or, you know, or do you pray for them? Because here's the qualification in Mark chapter 15. These signs shall follow them that believe. One of them is you can lay hands on the sick and they'll recover. You don't have to be no pastor, no minister, no teacher. You just have to be a believer. That's it. Are you in for real, or are you playing church? Who called this one? Call this one. And Pastor Derek nervous. Now you think I'm going to tell a story about when.
Listen to them.
No, I got to stand up and tell this story. We were over on Maple Street. Church was over on Maple Street. And they were having some kind of rehearsal for something. I don't know what they were doing there, but they were doing whatever. And Pastor Derek was there. So I called up the church and had the little phone right there by the door. Pastor Derek answered the phone. Hello? You know, one-way ministry. And I said, if you could tell me how to be saved, just like that. And Pastor Derek said, well, the pastor's not here right now. And I said, and I quote, you punk.
Right.
Yes, I did. No, the pastor's not here right now, boy. No, is God still using? No, you know what I mean. He wasn't all in. Praise God. We're just trying to determine if you're in. If you're in. Look at Matthew 4, 1 through 11. You're going to love this. It's going to call you. Then was Jesus led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward anhungered. And when the tempter came to him, he said, if thou be the Son of God, command these stones to be made bread. But he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Then the devil taketh him up into the holy city and setteth him on the pinnacle of the temple and saith unto him, if thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down, for it is written, he shall give his angels charge concerning thee, and in their hands they shall bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against a stone. Jesus said to him, it is written again, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. Again the devil taketh him up into an exceeding high mountain and showeth him all the kingdoms of the world and the glory of them, and saith unto him, all these things will I give thee, if thou wilt fall down and worship me. Then said Jesus unto him, get thee hence, Satan, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. Then the devil leaveth him, and behold, angels came and ministered unto him. Praise the Lord. The Bible talked about the devil tempting Jesus. That word tempted, when you see it in the Bible in this particular context, means to test, endeavor, to scrutinize or entice, or to discipline. To assay, examine, to go about, to prove, to tempt, or try. So, just so you get it, when the devil was tempting Jesus, he was doing the same thing. I'm trying to see if you're all the way in.
Right.
See how? Let me take you somewhere. I'm trying to see if you're all in. When the devil is doing what he's doing, when same thing when he's trying to tempt you. Let's see if you're in.
That's right.
Let's see if you're in. He's asking you the question. Are you in? How would you like to be a hit on this radio station? We got something for you. Let me see if you're in. How would you like this to happen? How would you like to have this? Wouldn't you like to be this? I feel sorry for pastors that don't really follow after the things that they teach or that the Bible teaches. You know, because I happen to know that there's a temptation for every pastor to be a money grubber. Give me the money. I'm going to have this, I'm going to have this, I'm going to have that, I'm going to have this. There's no way, and pastors I know have looked at me like I was crazy. The first time I went to Africa, and I was telling them, man, these folks are something. Man, we could do this. And, you know, we could have all these churches believing the truth, and they could grow, and they could do this. And they were saying, you know, I could teach them. I'm sending them this. I'm doing this stuff. And they were like, uh-huh, uh-huh. They're waiting. Like, and what you going to get? That, the glorified thing that God is doing.
Right.
That's what I'm getting. What were you looking for? What did you want? See, it didn't make sense to me either why I'm sending them money, thousands and thousands of dollars, and paying a mortgage on a church building. That didn't make sense to me. Pastor Keisha wanted to know, how can you be sending money to Africa? You got bills here, and here's a service, a Sunday service, where you collected $236 and $120 of it you put in. Uh-oh. I'm starting to wonder if I'm in the right church. You might not be okay in the head. God trying to see if we all in. Are you after the truth? Or are you trying to build a kingdom for you? Are you trying to see my truth go around the world? Or are you just thinking about you? See the enemy. He tries to tempt you with all sorts of things. And God wants you to understand that he's doing the same thing that God is asking you today. Are you in? He's trying to find out if you're all in. Let me see if I can get you to slip. Let me see if I can pull you out to this side or this side. I had several situations like this where people assumed, and they apologized. Yeah, well, you know, I'm sorry, man, but we're going to do this. Okay. You assume I'm looking for preaching dates. I'm not looking for preaching dates. I'm not. I have one every Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday. You know, I could preach all the times I want to. You know, but I understood. I realized after not long being a pastor that that's one of the things they go for, man. And I'm going to be here, and I'm speaking here, and I'm speaking here. Okay. What I want to know is, are you telling the truth there?
Right.
Oh, my God. Are you all the way in? That's what he's asking. See, some people aren't in unless somebody else who they feel connected to is in. Who you know, like you have a party or something. You tell them, I'm having a party. Who going to be there? Like, you ain't coming unless, you know, the people you want to be there. That's the way people treat the kingdom of God. You going to do that? You know, yeah. You know, that's how sometimes I baptized 7 people in one day. You know, only 4 or 5 of them still come to church. Right. You just got baptized because the other children were. No, that's good. On the one hand, but it indicates something, you're not really in. You know, I tell parents this, you know, your children, you know, they receive the Holy Ghost, they come to church with you and everything. You know, basically, they didn't have a choice. This is the only religion that was offered to them. So when they get to be 16, 17, along with that thinking they know everything, they're going to feel the same way about religion. You understand? You might have to let them go through that. Might have to let them go through that. You know, they'll find out. When you go out there and find out, none of that, okay, the rest of that foolishness is not true. What I told you was true. What I brought you to is true. In fact, you got the Holy Ghost and baptized in Jesus' name, and boy, that's wonderful. You just happen to be in the truth. But what God wants to know today is, are you really in? Are you in? Well, I go to a church, and we're apostolic. I don't really know apostolic, whatever. Are you in? Several people ask me that on Tuesday and Wednesday. What kind of church is it? Everybody wonder, what do? You work or are you retired? Oh, I'm a pastor. Oh, really? What kind of church is it? And, you know, I tell them, you know, well, we practice what the apostles did. What Jesus left with the apostles is what the church would be. That's what we practice. Oh, yes, I like my church. And my church, and they do this, and we do that, and we do that. I don't want to hear all that. And Camille going to come in and find out what is the schedule of his pain medication here. I have a general I'm married to, you know. The woman got all nervous. She didn't even know. Oh, well, this, he can take this. He can, I worry. Well, okay, that's right. But what is the schedule? We're supposed to stay ahead of the pain.
Right, right.
You're going to wait till he hurt and then start to. You got to wait till he hurt and then ask for it? Oh, my goodness. I put my head under the cover. Okay. I'm good, Camille. I don't hurt. I'm fine. Yeah. Oh, my God. Look. Here's what would happen. Some folks think they're in, but they're not really. You know? Some folks aren't in, you know, like we say, unless they're with somebody that's connected to it. But some folks, you think you're in, but you're not. If you know about Gideon's army, you know, he started off with 32,000 people.
Right.
And God told him, said, look, there's too many of y'all. Now, the Midianites had much more than that. He said, but there's too many of y'all, because if you go out there and win the battle, you're going to think he did it of your own power. So here's what I'm going to tell you, Gideon. I want you to find out who's really in. I want you to find out who's really in. Go out there and ask him. If you're a little bit scared, you can go home. We're not going to hold it against you. Go on home. 22,000 went. 22,000 left. Said, no, if we can go home and, you know, not be ashamed, because we're scared, then I'm gone. Well, the 10,000 of them were going on, and God told Gideon, now you have to understand how Gideon felt. First of all, you afraid to go yourself. You know, got me out there putting dew on just the carpet and all that, just to, you know, you're making me do all this crazy stuff with nature. I did it for you. You understand? So now you got these folks, and then I tell you, that's too many. That's too many. So I ask him to go home. All right. So he does that. He go home. Now he's got 10,000 people with him. And God told Gideon, if you look at Gideon, chapter 7, verses 2 and 3, it says, and the Lord said to Gideon, the people that are with thee are too many for me to give the Midianites into their hands, lest the Israelites vaunt themselves against me, saying, mine own hand has saved me. Now, therefore, go to, proclaim in the ears of the people, saying, whosoever is fearful and afraid, let him return and depart early from the Mount Gilead. And they returned from the people 22,000, and there remained 10,000. And verse 4 says this, and the Lord said to Gideon, the people are yet too many. Oh, my. What do you mean they're yet too many? They're yet too many. See, some of us ain't got but one call with God. Okay, God, I answered this. Okay, I did this. I can't go no more. Gideon had to answer another call. He said, the people that you got to are yet too many. Bring them down to the water, and I will try them there, and it shall be that of whom I say unto thee, this shall go with thee, the same shall go with thee. And of whomsoever I say unto thee, this shall not go with thee, the same shall not go. So of the 10,000 he had left, God said, I'm going to put them to the water test. They didn't get to the water if they drink like this, if they just fall down with their face in the water. They got to go. But if they put their hand in the water on one knee and lapping the water up, those that you keep. You see, of the 10,000, only 300 will really end. Some of us are more in than 22,000 others, but your mind is not on the battle all the time. See, once you put your face in the water, you're not thinking about the battle. You, there are people all around. You don't even know. But if you're on one knee looking up and looking around, the battle is still on your mind. No, there's many of them more ready than I'm more ready than him. I'm more ready than her. Well, she don't come to church, but every two times a month, I'm here all the time. But are you all in? That's the question God's asking us today. Are you in? I know they sliced your knee open, had it laid out flat, sawing off part of the bone, putting metal on it, put it back, get glued it together, taped it up and all that stuff, and, you know, got you taking all this medication. Oh, you know how it goes. Jamil had it done twice. It was hurting you to see her go through it. But are you all in? No, Camille will tell you. She told me, she said, what are you wearing? I said, I don't know. She said, scrubs. I said, okay, yeah, I wear scrubs. No, I'm cool. I got scrubs. I'm hip, you know. She said, you don't have to wear no suit and all that today and tie and everything. Oh, I said, oh, I don't have to wear a suit and tie because I'm playing with her now. She said, no, you don't have to wear all that. You know, I don't really agree with you being there. Yeah, but go ahead. She let it slip out. I know a lot of people ain't aware of me, okay, agree with me being here. But I'm all the evil Sunday in the bush. I'm all in. God didn't tell me you could get up and go to a physical therapy. You can get up and go from your room to the kitchen to get a cookie. If I don't give you no word, don't go. I'm in the 300. Now, here's this part in 1 Thessalonians 5. We're going to read 1 Thessalonians 5. This is to comfort you if you're in. You're in. This is a comfort to you. It's going to deal with a lot of issues that you might have in mind. But what about? No, you're in. This will comfort you. It said, but of the times and the seasons, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you. For you yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. For when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. But ye, brethren, are not in darkness, that the day should overtake you as a thief. You are all the children of light and the children of day. We are not of the night, nor of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. For they that sleep, sleep in the night, and they that be drunken are drunken in the night. But let us, who are of the day, be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet and hope of salvation. In other words, Paul says to the church at Thessalonica, come on now, we in this. You know, we're children of light. I don't have to tell you that. You don't have to be worried about, oh, when the world going in. And they say it's going to be this. And they say that's going to, you know, you flooding your mind with a bunch of foolishness. He said, of the times and seasons, you have no need that I write. You yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord comes as a thief in the night. Don't nobody know. But you're not worried about that because you're not of darkness. Why do you care? See, he's teaching something. Then he said, I like this part. He said, for God has not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by the Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with him. You have nothing to worry about. No. Ooh, and we're going to go through this, and there's the tribulation of it. You wasting your time. You're afraid for nothing. Obviously, God didn't appoint us to wrath. So how am I going to go through the wrath of God? That would make this a lie. Well, the Bible also says, I know it also says, but that doesn't get rid of this. It also says that about something else probably you don't understand. Anyway, he goes on, he says, wherefore comfort yourselves together and edify one another, even also as you do. And we beseech you, brethren, to know them which labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you. You need to know about Bishop and Pastor Derek and Minister Pathedia and Minister Shaitwan and Minister Yates and Minister Tracy. You, Pastor Keisha, you need to know about them. Because if they're going to be telling you stuff, admonishing you, and giving you information about them, well, hold up. I need to know about you. Are you in? Amen. I need to know if you're dedicated to the Lord. I need to know if you're really receiving things from God, or are you just telling me stuff that came off of your head when you heard the current events and stuff. I need to know if you're fearful. See, if you got a fearful spirit on you, that's going to get on me if I let you teach me. I'm going to be afraid. Know them that labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you. And to esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake. And be at peace among yourselves. Now we exhort you, brethren, warn them that are unruly, comfort the feeble-minded, support the weak, be patient toward all men. See that none render evil for evil unto any man, but ever follow that which is good, both among yourselves and to all men. Okay, here we go. Rejoice evermore. Pray without ceasing. In everything give thanks. But this is the will of God in Christ is concerning you. There's a couple of things that you have trouble with. Praying without ceasing. And in everything giving thanks. I'm praying. How am I going to pray without ceasing? Well, you should be talking to God all the time. In fact, he's talking to you now or waiting on you to listen. Right. I told you this before. You don't listen to what I'm saying. Listen to God telling you about what I'm saying. That's praying. Communicating with God. You're praying, but you should pray without ceasing. You shouldn't stop talking to God. And you know what makes people stop talking to God? They don't want to hear from God, and they're not going to say nothing to God when they're doing something they know they shouldn't be doing. In everything, give thanks. You know, somebody do something wrong to you, obviously wrong. Well, you're not going to say, oh, thank God. Thank you, Lord. But you ought to think about it. You know, why this happened? Maybe I need to thank God for this. You know, maybe I need to thank God that this occurred. You know, because 6 months, a year down the line, you're going to find out that God did something for your good. Like he said, all things work together for good to them that love God and are called according to his purpose. And then you're going to be saying, oh, I see why that happened. Wow. I like this one. It said, quench not the spirit. Despise not prophesying. Prove all things and hold fast that which is good. You got to prove things. You have to prove all things. Here's when you get caught, when I get caught, when something is occurring and I don't have time to prove it. I need a quick answer from God. Or I need one of them time, spirit things where you elude time. You break time and speak to me now as though it was yesterday. You know, I need to prove this. You know, Pastor Keach comes in and say, Bishop, is it okay if I say what God is telling me? Huh? I heard you the first time. What? I let it out. No, I heard you. What? I'm listening.
Come on, Bishop.
Yes, God said go. And the people said amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Quench not the spirit. You don't quench the spirit. You know, and I feel like it's an unfair thing for me because this was one of the first things that God taught me after I was saved. I hadn't been saved but a month or two like this. We go into a church, you know, they got 100 people in the choir, 100 choir robes, recording thing upstairs where they can record and all that kind of stuff. And, you know, I never thought about the size of churches and how big they are and what much that must be for prestige or anything. But God gave me something as I was studying the Bible, reading. I want you to say this to tell the pastor that you have this to say to the church. So I caught the pastor going through the little foyer area, and I said, hey, God gave me this. He wants me to say this to the church. And he said, oh, yeah, okay. And he just kind of patted me off. You know, we're not going to do that today, you know, like that. And I thought, man, he missed it. I know God told me that. I wasn't bitter or angry or anything. I just thought, gosh, you missed it. But that made me also understand, I don't care who you are or how long you've been a pastor or whatever. If I give somebody a word, you're not supposed to quench the spirit and you're not supposed to despise prophesying. Prove all things and hold fast to that which is good. When you find something that's good, hold fast to it. Verses 22 through 28 says, abstain from all appearance of evil. That's a hard one too. This is still, all these things are for you if you're in. So you forget. I don't want you to forget that. Because if you're abstaining from all appearance of evil, then you won't have those little conversations with yourself and God like this. Well, you know, are they really that bad? Is that, you know? You know, they believe that what they're doing too. Well, maybe if I'm with them for a while, they'll start to be like me. We hope they become better than you because you're not in. See, there's a difference in, you didn't go in with the thing of like this. If let's imagine that somebody here in church is sick. They start feeling sick in the chair. And one of the ushers or something go over to them and they say, oh, okay, well, I'm gonna get pastor or bishop to pray for you, something like that. And they just come like, but then they realize that, well, they're not, it's gonna be too awkward to do that. Geez, I'm gonna pray for you. No, God's gonna touch you. Hallelujah. I'm gonna pray for you. That's a whole lot different than if you go in armored up. There's something wrong with you. Wait, we'll cast that devil out of you right now. We don't. He can't interfere with the service at all. No, we'll take care of that now. We don't have to call nobody or whatever. But it works if you went in with that. No, I'm here facing you, devil. I'm fronting you off. He says, if you abstain from all appearance of evil and the very God of peace sanctify you wholly. And I pray, God, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Faithful is he that calleth you, who also will do it. Brethren, pray for us. Greet all the brethren with a holy kiss. I charge you by the Lord Jesus, by the Lord, that this epistle be read unto all the holy brethren. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen. Praise the Lord. Father, we thank you right now for what you do in our lives. We thank you, God, that you call us, that you bring us all the way with you. But Lord, we realize that there are times that you have to suffer us to be who we are until you can get us to be all the way in. God, now comes the time when you're asking. And even in you asking us now, Lord, I realize that you're giving us a moment. You're giving us a time, a chance, an opportunity to commit, to say, yes, I'm all in, Lord. To say, Lord, help me to be all in. To say, Lord, I need you to beat down this devil in my life. I need you to beat down this unbelief in my life. I need you to take care of this situation in my life. But Lord, I want to be all in. I want to be amongst the 300, Lord. I feel like I'm amongst the 10,000 right now. But God, I want to be in the last group, the ones that were all the way in, Lord. I know this situation looks crazy and wacky, and I'm going to look like a fool standing there with a woman who's pregnant, and you know, we're not even married yet. I need to say, I'm either a fornicator, an adulterer, or God, I'm a pure fool. My fiance is not right. But Lord, I know. I know that she's a virgin. I've heard what the angel of God says. No, I'm all in. No. We can look past that. Whatever it is, Lord, whatever you say. Whatever you say, Lord. Bless your name. God, I put so many fleeces out. You responded so many times. You suffered me to go through so many of these things, Lord. Lord, I need to be all in. All in. In your hearts and minds right now. Think about the things that are hindering you. Think about the things that are holding you from completely doing what God would have you do. From doing everything that God said in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, God.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
On everything, everything, Lord.
Right now, God. In Jesus'
name. I believe.
Yes. Yes.
I believe, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Able shot. Under it up above shot. I want the real thing. Not the things we do to cover up what we really called to. Come on, I was called to this, but I'm doing this, Lord. Yes, but I called you to something else. Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Father, right now in your name. Come on, the fullness of truth. Everything that God said. Come on, I believe, Lord. I believe. I should be believing right now. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Jesus. Father, right now, fulfill your will. Come on, you got to give him all of yourself now. You got to give him all of yourself now. Jesus. Nothing back. Holding nothing back. Jesus. Glory. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on, this is your day. Come on, this is your day. Yeah, this is it. This is your day. He brought you here for this moment. For this moment. For this moment. Yes. Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Come on, let him have it. Come on, you're safe. Jesus. Jesus. Jesus' name. Come on. Come on, let it all go. Nothing hindering. Devil can't play no games with you anymore. Devil can't play no games with you. Asha. Jesus' name. I'm letting it go. Yes, that's it. Come on, let it go. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, church, let's give him one more praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away. So you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away.
so you can use me. I give myself away. Oh Lord, I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. Hallelujah. I give myself away so you can use me. Say, my life is not my own. To you I give myself. My life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself. Oh, my life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself. I give myself. I give myself away. Oh Lord, I give myself away so you can use. I give myself. I belong to you. I give myself away so you. I give myself. Oh, I give myself so you can you. I give myself.
Hallelujah, Lord. We give you glory and honor, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. My God, my God, my God. Thank you, Jesus. Our service times are listed in the bulletin. We thank God for you, all that have came today. If you're a guest and if you've never filled out a guest package, please make sure you fill one out and find an usher before you leave or drop it in the guest box. Please remember to pray for the lost, the sick, the backslidden, and for our fellowship and for all of our associated churches. If you have any prayer needs, please text or call Minister Camille Moten. Her number is listed in the bulletin. We will continue to have a time of prayer, testimonies, and teachings on various topics on Miracle Mondays at 11 a.m. here at the church. Please feel free to attend. And if you're free anytime between noon and 1 p.m. on Wednesdays, please join us here for prayer. Even if you can only stay for 10 to 15 minutes, come and agree in prayer. Just a reminder, Sister Porter would like to meet with all the junior church teachers directly after service. Are there any other announcements? Yes. Dance rehearsal is at 7 this Friday. Any other announcements? Praise the Lord. Are we having the bake sale? Because I saw some cookies go out there. So, okay, so we're having the bake sale. Praise the Lord. We're dismissed in Jesus' name, and grab a cookie when you're on where.